Buenos dias, TECO students. My name is Abraham Madrigal, but I will refer myself in this podcast as Counselor Abe. I'm a full-time counselor at Sacramento State, which is one of the 23 CSUs, and I also work as a part-time counselor at Sacramento City College. I am one of the counselors creating informational content for TECO. In this podcast, I would like for you to get to know me. So I will be sharing several things about myself, my educational journey, such as where I went to school, and I'll be ending by leaving you with a valuable tip for college success. I was born in Las Estacas, Michoacán, Mexico. My parents and I migrated to the US when I was 6 years old. For many years, we lived in Antioch, which is considered the East Bay area. In Antioch, we lived in a very, very low income housing. And as a matter of fact, it was poverty level with high crime and drugs as well. I remember hearing gunshots every other day. And, you know, this essentially became the norm while I was growing up in the projects. My parents always told my siblings and I to just stay away from certain people and that we would do just fine. In 2011, as a senior in high school, we migrated to a very small ag town called Galt because my dad had lost his job and my cousin got him a job in agriculture. I never thought I was going to graduate from high school because I thought that transferring from high school to high school within 1 semester remaining of school would not be enough for me to meet the Galt high school graduation requirements. Thankfully, I did graduate high school. But most importantly, though, I am thankful that we moved because I was able to connect with my cousin, who at that time was attending Sacramento State. He was the one that got me into Sac State. After finishing high school, my goal was not to attend college. I actually wanted to work at Best Buy, actually. However, I applied and applied and was never hired. During my time, my cousin had asked me for my high school transcript and my parents' income tax. And just to make this long story short, he completed my CSU application as well as my FAFSA, which is the application to pay for college. A couple of months later, I received a notification through mail that I was accepted to Sacramento State and that I needed to attend Summer Bridge, which is a summer program under the Educational Opportunity Program. I had to attend Summer Bridge because I was not college level and I needed to meet certain requirements for admissions, and Summer Bridge was one of them. So then that year in 2011, I moved to Sacramento and began going to Sacramento State right after high school. While attending Sac State, I had no clue what to major in. I ended up selecting communication studies because I love talking about sports and I figured that I could one day be a sports anchor. However, before graduating, I got an internship with the EOP program. The same program that got me in when I first started going to Sac State. As an advisor, that was the internship that I was obtained through EOP. As an EOP advisor, I loved the job. I really love giving back to students that were like myself, that were first generation, that were low income. And I really, really enjoyed this internship that I had with EOP. So shortly after graduating with my bachelor's in communication studies, I decided to apply to the master's program, then SIM school at Sac State for counseling because I wanted to be a counselor. I figured that the internship experience, being an advisor for the program, really gave me the knowledge and experience and really what I really love doing. So I figured that the counselor route would be, you know, one of my dream jobs to be a counselor. So I applied after graduating from the bachelor's, which took me about 4.5 years. I applied for the master's program at Sac State in counseling, and I successfully completed the program. I did 3 years there at Sac State for the master's in counseling. And I'm still a student. I'm still a student like you all listening to this podcast. I am actually a third year student attending University of the Pacific, pursuing a doctorate program. Never, never in a million years would I imagine being a doctoral student. I went from struggling on how to write a 2-page essay during Summer Bridge, you know, 10 years ago in 2011, to now working and completing a dissertation study which can be anywhere from over 100 pages, you know, or even 200 pages of a document. So that leads me into giving you a tip of advice. A tip of advice that I followed throughout my 10 years in education, and I continue to follow to this point, and that is persistence. This means asking for help more than once to the same or different people that are going to help you reach your goals. I would never be where I am now if it wasn't for my persistence and always asking for help. There are certain individuals that are going to help you, you know, reach your goals. Identify who they are and continue to ask for help. You might see it as you're bugging them, but let me tell you, that's how I saw it as well. But then one of my good advisors told me, Abraham, I never sat here and told myself that you're bugging me. That has never crossed my mind. But your persistence shows that you're really intrigued and you're really motivated to reach your goals. So that's my tip for college success, is being persistent. Being persistent in reaching your goals. Again, my name is Counselor Abe, and I will see you at graduation.